And then I won the club competition, and then I wanted to win the state championship, and then I wanted to win the national championships, and then I wanted to represent my country, and then of course I wanted to be an Olympian.
2000 was my first Olympics. I was only 16, I think, that time. I was just happy to be there. 2004, I really believed that I could win. I came very close. And 2008,
when the rest of the world talks about Indian sport, they use the word potential, potential, and potential. But at that moment, no Indian had ever won an individual gold medal, and it had been 28 long years since we won a team event.
So we can have different talents, but I think just natural ability and natural talent will not get you where you aspire to be. You have to supplement it with a lot of hard work.
Abhinav Bindra bringing the gold. What a historical moment for India.
From within, I was so happy and I was so fulfilled. I achieved what I set out to do. All the sacrifices that I made, all the belief that all my family had in me and my coaches had in me.
I think even if you're pursuing sport, I think to have an education is critical. The way sport is in the Western world, there is a lot of science, there's a lot of technology to it, which has not yet been completely embraced in our country. However, it is essential to embrace that because it is unbelievable what all goes into training athletes. And
I think sport, of course, teaches you how to win, but more importantly, it teaches you how to lose. It teaches you the necessity to work hard, to have honesty, to have integrity. It teaches you the need to have a goal and to pursue it. With all these values, it teaches you to engage in conflict as well, with a spirit of friendship and respect.
Whatever might be your dream, your passion, give it all that it asks of you, your commitment and dedication. Invest in the relationships that the pursuit of your dreams bring you, the ones that make you uncomfortable, challenge you, tease you, upset you. These are often the most valuable ones. Be there for each other in good times and bad, regardless of how much you end up achieving, and may it be a lot, you will have memories, relationships, and experiences. It is more than a fair bargain.
We're all after economic success and, you know, trying to become a successful economy, a $5 trillion economy and all that kind of stuff is often talked about. But what is very interesting to see is, you know, all the great economic powers around the world also happen to be great sporting superpowers. And I believe that's not happened by accident, that they're good economies. You know, they've all these successful people, all these successful business houses have all imbibed values from sport as young boys and girls. And I'm sure they remain true to them and true to their entire pursuit in whatever form or shape that takes. So this is my endeavor. I'm really committed to this, very passionate about it, because I think it can play a hugely impactful role in nation building.